Thousands of children will wake up this morning with one of their parents in prison. But in a specialised unit of Auckland Women's Prison, the babies will wake up with their mums. Q&A reporter Indira Stewart approached Corrections and was granted exclusive access to the Mothers and Babies Unit to find out what life is like for babies behind bars.
Most would think a prison is no place for a child. But this Auckland Women's Prison has been welcoming babies and raising them inside for the past decade.
Control, can I have gate 4, please?
Taylor Yandel is the prison director and says the babies who live here in a special unit are treated like guests.
They are innocent, they are, we try and make sure that we are providing them every opportunity that they would have whilst they are in here as a child. They're not penalised for being in here. They're not disadvantaged.
And they're not prisoners here?
No, they're not.
Tell me what the babies are like.
No, oh, they're gorgeous, yeah. Yeah, so different personalities. It's so nice to see some of them grow, get more confident. Definitely is a highlight, I think, for me sometimes, is going and seeing them and seeing how much they've developed over time.
The Mothers and Babies Unit here is just a short walk from Taylor's office. Prisoners who are pregnant or who have a young baby can apply under a strict criteria to serve their sentence here. By law, all babies in the prisons must leave by the age of 2. Mary's son was just 4 months old when she entered prison last year.
There's like a whole process. So yeah, it was a bit of a while until he actually got to be with me.
So tell me what your first day was like here in the Mothers and Babies Unit.
It was real emotional. I was so emotional, and I think it was different for him too, because he was wondering, like, where am I? I put him in his cot, but I just couldn't stop staring at him. So I was just like, oh my gosh, like, I got my baby here with me.
Is it okay?
Mary was sentenced for a range of convictions, including aggravated robbery, theft and assault. She's honest about her past, but is trying to stay positive for her future.
Is there much regret for some of the actions that we're taking that have led you here?
Yeah. I'm on the flip side of things and I'm learning and I'm growing. My upbringing wasn't the best. I had my struggles with growing up. And then, yeah, I made some pretty not very wise decisions. Yeah, I guess I wasn't in the best place.
What is it?
Being inside means Mary is separated from her oldest son. Like her, the majority of women in prison are the primary caregivers in their families.
We have a lot of mothers, we have a lot of sisters, aunties. A lot of them still hold quite a dominant role within their whānau whilst they are in our care. So it is really important for us to make sure that we maintain those connections even though they are in our care.
Data from Corrections found 75% of women prisoners have experienced family violence, sexual assault and rape. Three quarters were also diagnosed with a mental health condition within the past year. 66% of our women prisoners are Māori.
The resilience, I think, for some of these, behind some of these wahine, the level of resilience for them to essentially still function and be a pivotal part of their whānau and actually still be able to contribute to their whānau, they're still wanting to engage in education, engage in programs, make sure that they are doing everything that they can here to make sure that they can provide for their whānau when they do get released.
Big yawn.
In a year from now, Mary's baby will have to leave the prison unit. If she serves her full sentence, he'll be 7 years old by the time she gets out.
I'm not trying to count down the days, but it is something that I've kind of had to prepare myself for, trying to put things in place for him so when he eventually does leave, in the back of my mind, I know I've done the best I could to set him up to succeed out there.
Is it hard to think about?
It is. It really is when I think about it, but it's something that I have to prepare myself for. So,
the goodbyes are hard for everyone.
Not just myself, but as my staff who actually specifically work in that area, you do become quite attached. It's not always possible that timing-wise, with regards to sentences and that they are able to leave at the same time as baby. But where it is possible, we do try and facilitate that.
Taylor says if Mary can put in the work needed, she could be before a parole board with the chance of leaving much sooner. Mary says she wants to turn her life around.
Just to be stable and be reliable, provide for them in like a good way, the right way. And yeah, I just want to be just that person for my sons. I want them to grow into young, strong men and good men and just have good values, respect women, respect your elders, love people, you know, be kind.
What's one thing you'd change about your past today?
Just to actually just stop and think, like, everything has a consequence.
Mary's baby will join the roughly 17,000 children in Aotearoa with parents in prison.
We know from our research that children who have parents in prison are around nine and a half times more likely to one day become incarcerated themselves. However, we don't see our children as New Zealand's future prisoners. We don't see our children as New Zealand's future statistics. We see them as New Zealand's future leaders.
Karina Thompson is the Senior Mentoring Coordinator at Pillars. The charity has been supporting children of prisoners and their families for the last three decades. These are some of the young people she's worked with who grew up with parents in prison. They're now calling on the government to urgently put care plans in place for kids with parents behind bars.
Currently, there is no such legislation that safeguards young people or whānau when a parent is sent to prison or on a community sentence. We would love to see families and young people co-design these care plans that get put in place for long-term outcomes.
Well, there are some people in New Zealand who might think, well, you know, you've done the crime and it's not our responsibility to think about, you know, the consequences of your children.
All Kiwis want a safe and effective justice system. All Kiwis want a safe and happy society. The way that we do that is by following the evidence. We know from global research, from local research, it is consistent that when families are able to maintain those strong relationships, it reduces reoffending, it reduces reincarceration, it also reduces intergenerational incarceration.
The data also shows the majority of mothers who raised their babies in prison don't reoffend. Strengthening relationships with their kids motivates change.
Do you worry at all about normalising prison for some of these children?
I think it's not so much around normalising prison, it's more, from my perspective, it's more maintaining a relationship and making sure that we are not subjecting the baby or the mother to unnecessary trauma around that.
And the women here are not forgotten on Mother's Day.
This year we are planning for our wahine to have a cake for each wing and we are providing cards for them to send out to their children and loved ones as well. They get a gift pack, which is a pack of donated goods through our chaplaincy service and other various community groups they donate.
It's Mary's first Mother's Day in prison, and she's determined to break the cycle for her sons. She says having her baby with her has given her hope for their future.
It's made me realise that it's a start to something new. My life I have with my children now, it's a whole different beginning. So life's not really over for us, it's only just starting. Yeah, there's so much things that we're gonna do together. So much things for us to see.